The Sisters. Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence. I love the Sisters. And I'm so happy that one of them in that video had the Israeli flag. I have my qualms about the Israeli government, but I love that there is a Jewish state. Right on. I have the wrong glasses on, girlfriend. When you do a Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence, you have to have the right spectacles there. I had, once I was working at the Cyclops Cafe in Belltown, beautiful Belltown, and is the AIDS benefit Dine Out for Life, which I just did a couple months, was it last month or the month before? I went to Columbia City, but when I was working Cyclops Cafe, we had the Dine Out for Life, and we had the Sisters come, the Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence, and I had them autograph my Extreme Teen Bible. And there we are. We have Sister Fair Clairvoyant, Sister Eva Destruction, Sister Donna Creation, Sister Allison Chase, and Sister Sharon Sharealike. And they, there they are. That's the one I can't really quite pronounce. Sister Allison Chase. Anyway, and so they signed my Extreme Teen Bible. Extreme Teen Bible. Just a future with a promise. No future for you. No future for me, girlfriends, because I'm having a horrible writer's block. And I think that's what it is. It must be, I can't, you know, I just, last month I finished writing a new, you know, I completed a new book, so I should be feeling creative and sustained, fulfilled as a writer. But I have another book that I've been trying to write, and I want to have that book finished by the end of this year. And that is a book of mostly prose poems. You would think prose poems would be so easy to write, and they are not. To do it well, not that I do it well, I do it as well as I can. It's really work. I can't get back into the groove. I was doing really well with them, and I think I'm in a kind of a block. Now, when I'm in a writer's block, my solution is to read. One of the things I read is the Bible, because the Bible is one of the strangest books in all of history. And it often inspires the darkness within me. I've also been, I do need my reading glasses. There. I've been reading Edward Hirsch's The Angel and the Demon, searching for the source of artistic inspiration. It's a wonderful, wonderful book. I've been reading An Introduction to the Prose Poem, which so far is quite excellent. I've started reading Psyche Reborn, The Emergence of H.D. She was so beautiful. Hilda Doolittle. I've been reading the Complete Short Fiction of Oscar Wilde. And I've been reading the wonderful prose poems of Charles Baudelaire. And I've been reading Gershom Scholem, one of my favorite Jewish scholars, The Messianic Idea in Judaism, and other essays in Jewish spiritualism. Oh, and I've been reading Built on Books, How Reading Defined the Life of Oscar Wilde. And that's what I do when I want to get inspired, is I read. I read and I read and I read. And that usually inspires me. But I'm feeling really blocked. For me, writing is often, half of writing is the mental work. It's you read, you dream, you think, you write down your little notes, and that's a lot of the work. The work is mental. And it requires a mental discipline, which I lack, alas. So I'm feeling kind of frustrated, but to help me, I am going to start reading some of the Old and New Testament in my Extreme Teen Bible, which was signed by the delectable and the wonderful Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence. They do such great work for the cause of AIDS. They raise a hell of a lot of money, and they are divine. I love you all, my darling sisters. I wish all of my queer brothers and sisters a very happy, safe, and fabulous Pride weekend. Shalom, my darling.